We're gonna model this structure with R elements, and we will post-process the results. And I sketched this in the XZ plane, and now we're gonna go to the FEM environment. This is pre-post in NX12. In NX10, you can go to advanced simulation. Then we go to new FEM simulation. This is important, but standards in NX use only bodies, but in this case you have to select that you want to use sketch curves to the finite element environment. So that is okay. And we're gonna use structural, that's okay. Most easy thing to do with working with 1D elements is to use create a mesh collector. 1D element, and we're gonna use a bar collector. You could also use a beam collector, but bar is the simple version of a beam collector. The bar means that's from the library. So if you select an option, he calculates some parts automatically, and you so you don't have to hand it in. Then we go to off, and then we go to the four section, create. That's why it's in the library, and you get 6 times 12. I'm gonna all the way around. That's probably the good method. Have a preview. Okay, set. We'll see that, and you can see the properties of this section. And you can see here the recovery points. This is important when you look at the stresses. Okay. That's done. Close. Then we don't really start in the properties. We assign steel to it, and we name this bar 6 times 12. Okay. We scrolled it a little bit down. We scrolled it up. Then we have probably okay. Mesh collector. Then we're gonna create the 1D mesh. It's important. You can take the bar element. This is that the directions is okay, and we'll merge nodes. Default is out. That the both nodes at the end and beginning of that bar are merged to one node, so that it will be a rigid. Let me see, then we have to select this one and this one. Okay. Then we we show the mesh. Oh, I did it. The most beginner's error, I did not what I did not do, and I always forget. When you create this, this was automatically on. Now this will be taken automatically, that I forgot to deselect the automatic creation, resulting in that small problem. Then we go to loading. Oh no, that's not what I want to do. I want to show that how add a display. And curves, let me see, yes, it's the correct what I wanted. You want to have, I want to put this force that way, and you want height in your construction. Okay, loads, load type, force. Be aware that if you click the force, you select the line, and I want to put the path on your node. Set was okay already predefined in this case. Okay, then we fix one D elements have 6 degrees of freedom, and I want to only select the point. So we can use fix, otherwise it will rotate. Seems to get force is okay. Okay, I forgot, not forgot something, because we want to analyze the stresses more carefully. We have to case control output request edit, and we have to enable the force. Otherwise, we cannot see the stresses around the intersection. So now we can solve. Yes. Okay. I hope it's we did everything okay. So, and we're gonna see to this. This always selected. Look if the displacement is okay. That seems to be okay. Then we go to the bending stress, because the element is always made up this way. Y element, Z and X element is in the perpendicular. The XX stress is here the bending stress. This comes from the element PDF from Nastran documentation from Siemens. It's a nice read for the difference between beams and bars. Okay, stress elemental nodal XX is the stress. You see here an average XX, and you see zero because here has no bending force, creating lots of bending force for the bending stress XX. You can look at other paths, then you have to go to set result, the same probably in NX10, and you can see the recover point, and then you select another one. I hope I did the correct one, because you have to on the other side, then the values become opposite. This minus 90 should become, and approximately 90. Yes, that's okay. So there you can see the results, but you can also see the review, the results in the intersection. Then let me see, then this should be, it's normally lit, beam result selected, and okay, and then you can get to beam cross section, and to select a point, and then you see, because the bending is less, the values are opposite, so this is the result you want to have. If we, when you look here, then probably XZ is the bend, the shear stress, and we have a look for that ZX, and you see point C is the outside, so bending stress always on the outside. So we gonna get again put this on. I don't know why that's flipping away, and then Control F. Let me see. Yeah, this way. Then you select somewhere point, and you see the shear stress is highest in the middle, and at the end is zero. Okay, this completes the result from creating a bar in NX12, and it's also possible in NX10. Only the menus here are a little bit different.